So let us know something about superimposition. It's called Adhyasa in Sanskrit. Now we are sitting in a train and suddenly train appears to be moving. Nam train move aagta kanutha. Nijavagalu nam train move aagta, pakka train move aagta. Nam train hodaga kanutha munde. Yenaytu? What happened really?
Illusion.
Our train move aagta, but nam train
still there.
Appearing to be moving. Alva? It's a optical illusion. Okay? ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಧ್ಯಾಸ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಯಾವುದು ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಬೇರೆ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಅದು ನಮ್ಮ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಮುಂದೆ ಕಟ್ತದೆ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಷನ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಧ್ಯಾಸ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಗೆ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಬೋಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಇನ್ ಎ ಲೇಕ್ ಬೋಟಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಬೋಟಿಂಗ್ ರಿವರ್ ದ ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಮರಗಳಾಗ್ತಾ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಮೋಟ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಬೋಟು ಆದರೆ ಕಾಣ್ತೀರೋ ಮರಗಳು ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಕಾಣ್ತದೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯೂಚುವಲ್ ಸೂಪರಿಂಪೋಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಅಧ್ಯಾಸ ಇದೇ ಅಧ್ಯಾಸ ಆತ್ಮನ ಮೇಲೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಈಗ ಪ್ರಪಂಚ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ನನಗೆ ಕಾಣು ನೋಡು ನಾನು ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ 5 ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಪಂಚಭೂತಗಳಿಂದ ಆಗಿದೆ ಪ್ರಪಂಚ ಆಕಾಶ ವಾಯು ಅಗ್ನಿ ಪೃಥ್ವಿ ಜಲ ಆಪ The world made up of 5 elements appears in front of us. And I am also made up of 5 elements. Nanu kuda panchabhutagalinda agide 5 elements. Okay? And I feel I am separate from the world. Prapanchadan bere anta anubhava bartha nanage. Alva? Idu prapancha eshtu doddappa? How big is the world? Eshtella complications, eshtella jagada, eshtella samasye, horadata. How many troubles I have in the world? Right? Different kinds of troubles. And this analogy given in Vedanta is called Sarpa. A serpent. The world is appearing to be as a serpent. It's fearful. Hedrike aagtade. Right? You're scared of the complexity in the world. Because the world is vast, infinite, and I am small. Naan sannavanu, prapancha doddadu. Prapancha kashta sukha ide. Nanage kashta sukha agutte, I am also suffering. So this is the feeling. And that's why adakke heltare samsara anta, the world. Ee prapancha andre hedarike karana agutte. It's why it's called serpent. It looks like a serpent. Haavena kanutide. Appa this actually is a superimposition. So you contemplate on the teachings of Vedanta chintane maadi chintane maadidaga aham brahmasmi nanu brahma nanu chaitanya anu arivu bartade okay the snake was not there actually rope appeared like a snake it's called rajju sarpa hagga havina kaantu iga now you see the hagga You see the real, earlier the rope appeared like a serpent, right? There's no rope, there's no serpent actually, hagga illa. So where was the serpent actually, sarpa illitto?
Superimposition.
Where was that?
On the rope.
Manasu. Mind superimposed on the serpent, alva. So then the world appeared. There's no world actually. ಪ್ರಪಂಚ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಶುದ್ಧ ನಾನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಇತ್ತು ದಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ ಕನಸಲ್ಲಿ ಮಲ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀರ ಮಲ್ಕೊಂಡು ಕೂಡಲೇ ಸಡನ್ನಾಗಿ ಸಿಂಡ್ರಲ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀರ ಅಪ್ಪಾ ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಸಿಂಡ್ರಲ್ ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ಸ್ವಿಟ್ಜರ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಏನದು ಹಾಂ ಸಮ್ ಟೂರ್ ಸ್ಕೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರ ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲು ಹುಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀರ ಕೊಡೋ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀರ ಓಕೆ ಎಚ್ಚರ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ you go to Switzerland and you do skiing and you fall down and your leg is broken and you wake up. No Switzerland, no Cinderella. Where was Cinderella? Where was Switzerland?
Dream.
Switzerland is the Cinderella is broke.
Dream.
What was there earlier?
Dream.
Without Cinderella, without dream, what was there? Any Tali? What was there earlier?
World.
I was sleeping, so there was no Cinderella, there was no world, right? So suddenly you took a body called Cinderella and it was the world. So where was Cinderella and the world? It was the mind. The mind generated Cinderella and the world, right? The same mind is generating this world. And world is superimposed on the I. Nano. When I say world is actually five elements. Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Jala, Prathvi. ಈ ಪಂಚಭೂತಗಳಿಂದ ಆದ ಪ್ರಪಂಚವನ್ನು ನಾನು ಅನ್ನೋದ ಮೇಲೆ ಆರೋಪ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಇದು ಪ್ರಪಂಚ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಮಾಯೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕನಸು ಕಂಡಾಗೆ. ಯು ಸಿ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹಗ್ಗ ಇತ್ತು, ಹಾವಾಗಿ ಕಾಣ್ತು, ರಜ್ಜು ಸರ್ಪ ಇದ್ದದ್ದು ಹಗ್ಗ, ಕಂಡದ್ದು ಹಾವು. ಸೊ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಆಸ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಶ್ರವಣ ಮನನ ನಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಕಾಂಟೆಂಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ದ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇದಾಂತ ಆತ್ಮವಿಚಾರ, ಯು ಸಿಟ್ ಇನ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ರೀಚ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ನಿಧ್ಯಾಸ. ನಿಧ್ಯಾಸಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲ, ಪ್ರಪಂಚ ಇಲ್ಲ, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ದಿ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸಪಿಯರ್, ರೈಟ್? ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೈಲೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪೀಸ್ಫುಲ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಸತ್, I am conscious, chit, no thoughts to bother me, ananda, satchidananda, you experience in nididhyasa. Satchidananda vanna nididhyasa le anubhavistira. And that's called Brahman. Where is the world now? Prapancha ilide? Huh? You know? Allare nididhyasa ku prapancha ilide pa?
Disappear.
It has disappeared. It was not there. Mind imagined and projected. Okay? So it disappeared. Then your nature is revealed. What is your nature? Sat, Chit, Ananda. I exist, I am conscious, I am blissful. Satchidananda Rupai, Nam Kanbane. Every day happens in sleep. That's why you have discussed with Miss Sushupti. Okay, only thing is the sleep, I am awareness is missing. So now then learning has to happen to I am awareness. So that is the purpose. Is it clear? So now there's no snake. There's rope only, peaceful. Aita? Again you come back. Igapana Bandri. Now you woke up. You came up from meditation. So what happens, Preeta Ram? Can you see the snake? ಈಗ ಹಾಗ ಹಾವು ಕಾಣ್ತೋ ಹಾಗೆ ಕಾಣ್ತೋ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಯು ಸಾ ದ ರೋಪ್, ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ರೋಪ್? ರೋಪ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ರಿಯಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್, ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್. ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ, ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ನಾನು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಅದೇ. ಈಗ ಪುನಃ ಈಗ ಹಾವು ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು, ಏನು ಹಾವಿಲ್ಲ, ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ಈಗ ಪುನಃ ಬಂತು ಎಚ್ಚರಾದ ಮೇಲೆ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ನೌ ಡಸ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ನೇಕ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್? ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಸ್ನೇಕ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೋಪ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್? ನೌ ನೋ ನೋ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಎಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ನೇಕ್, ಬಟ್ ನೋ ಮೋರ್ ಫಿಯರ್. ದ ಫಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಾನ್ ನೌ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ರೋಪ್. ಅಪಿಯರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಲ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನೋನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್, ದಿಸ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್. See, you saw a snake, hugger, how nodidre, and you got scared, turn the light, then you saw its rope, then you switched off the light, then its snake is there. Now, you see the snake again, are you seeing its snake or rope?
Snake.
What do you call it as? Because light is dim only, no? You see the rope as snake only. But now it's no, you know, rope. What will it say? It says snake is there, rope is there, you said. Rope is there. Similarly, once you meditate, nididhyasa, open your eyes, the world is there. Now what is the world? Huh? But what is there really? Here what is there?
Rope.
Brahman. The world also becomes Brahman as you go in more and more, meditate and come back. That will be Brahman only remain. Okay? Are you getting? So the it is appearing like world because of your impressions, vasanas. So the more again and again you go to nididhyasa, the vasanas will go. But
it takes time. That means
it doesn't take time.
No. What I'm telling you is you have to keep on doing meditate for a long time.
No, my dear. So did you do nididhyasa?
Yes.
Okay. What did you see?
I am.
So what did you infer?
Everything is I am.
So now when you open your eyes, then again world is there. So what is there really?
I am Brahman.
That's all. Brahman is there. That's all is understanding. Now you have some little bit of vasanas. So even after vasana goes, for a jnani also the world will appear like that only. Because eyes are there. Sense organs are there. But he knows. Only if you do nididhyasa only once also, you know that it's Brahman. You don't have to do 10 times to do this. You see a snake, one hagga nodidre. How nodidre? ಟಾರ್ಚರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಾವು ಟಾರ್ಚರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹಾವು ಒಂದು ಹಗ್ಗ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಸೊ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ನಿಧಿಯಾಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತದೆ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಪುನಃ ಬಂದು ನಿಧಿಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನನ್ನ ವಾಸನೆ ಇರ್ತಾವೆ ಖಾಲಿ ಆಗ್ತವೆ ವಾಸನೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ವಾಸನೆ ಸರ್ ಪ್ರಪಂಚ ಹಾಗೆ ಕಾಣುತ್ತದೆ ಪ್ರಪಂಚ ಏನು ಬದಲಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಆಯ್ತಾ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇವನ್ ವಿತ್ ಒನ್ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ನಾಟ್ 10 ಡೈವ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಅಕಂಪನಿಡ್ ಬೈ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಜ್ಞಾನ Before you do nidhyasa, you have to do atma-vichara, then you do nidhyasa. Then it's once for all solution. Are you clear? Yes or no?
Yes.
What did you understand?
Once we do the snake, once I snake, then just take it as the snake. Then I do nidhyasa. Then I realize, and once we come back, we see it as Brahman, we see it as...
You don't have to do 100 times nididhyasa, but one time clear jnana is required. Jnana is, which atma vichara is one time. Okay, clearly. Atma vichara 100 times, that's not it. Nimga one time clear, it's not. But vichara madi. But once you clear, nididhyasa madi, one time. That is called realization. So next time is just a repetition. ಅರ್ಥ ಏನು ಪ್ರತಿಭಾ ಹೇ ಗುರುಜಿ ವೆನ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕೇಳಿ ನನಗೆ ಯಾವ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕೇಳಿ ದೆನ್ ಐ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ದೆನ್ ಐ ಸೇ ಮಿಸ್ ಐ ಮಿಸ್ ಜಾಗೃತಿ ಆರ್ ಯು ಮಿಸ್ ಜಾಗೃತಿ ನೋ ನೋ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯುಆರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆರ್ ವೈ ಆರ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಮಿ ದಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಐ ಆಸ್ಕ್ See, this concept that I have to do many times is also false. That's not the teaching of Vedanta. One time, if you understand it clearly, one time you get into nididhyasa, you are understood. So next time onwards, it's just to reduce vasanas. Okay? It is not that 100 times you do and then realize, that's false. So that is a totally false against Vedantic teaching. Vedantic Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa is one time, one effort. So nididhyasa 100 times you do, No. Nididhyasa you do again and again to reduce some residual vasanas. Jnana is one time. Once you do Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. Idhile Atma Vichara, complete clarity, do Nididhyasa. Finished. Right? So then again you may get Atmana because this Miss, who is it? Which Miss is come up?
Jaja.
Miss Jaja.
That's what I was trying to tell.
Who is trying to tell?
That either we get into...
No, who is I, who is we?
That I...
Who is I and who is we? I mean, he is also included?
That is I and we.
Who is that I?
I is of course Atma. What happens is that ishtu varshadu kola iriyala.
Allappa, ishtu varshadu kola yaarigittu? Atmanigittu or miss, ivaligitta?
Miss gittu.
So, ni miss niva?
ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ,
ಅದು ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗೋದು ವಾಸನೆ.
ಅದು
ವಾಸನೆ,
ಅದೇ ಹೇಳೋದು.
ಆ ವಾಸನೆ ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪುನಃ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು. ನೀವು ಏನ್ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳಿದ್ರೆ ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ ಹಲವಾರು ಸಲ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ ಬಂತು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಆ ಮಿಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಿಸ್
ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನು
ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು,
ಬಟ್ ಏನು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದೇ ನಾವು ದಿನ ದಿನ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಎದ್ದು ತಿರ್ಗಾ
ಅಲ್ಲ ಅದೇ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ
ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್
ನಮ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಐ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೇರ್ ದ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ನೋ ರಾಂಗ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾಧನ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಜ್ಞಾನ, ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಜ್ಞಾನ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ರಾಂಗ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್. ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಒನ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್, ಒನ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಜ್ಞಾನ, ಯು ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ದೆನ್ ರಿಪಿಟೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ರಿಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಾಸನ. ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ ವಾಸನ ಸಿಕ್ಕೋದೇ ನಾವು ಗೆಟ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಉಲ್ಟಾ. ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್? ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತು ಸರ್ ನಿಮಗೆ? ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೋಟಲಿ ರಾಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇದಾಂತ. ಓಕೆ, ವೇದಾಂತ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ರೆಕಗ್ನಿಷನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ದೆನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಡೂ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ವಾಸನಕ್ಷಯ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ, ಎರಡು ರೀತಿಯ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಇದೆ, ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೀಕರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಆಫ್ ದ ನೋವರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾರೆ ಜನ ಸೀಕರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನೋವರ್ ಅಂತ. ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಸೀಕರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಓಕೆ ಇವರಿದ್ರು ಯಾರು, ದಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಬೃಹದಾರಣ್ಯಕ ಉಪನಿಷತ್ತಿನವರು ಯಾರು, ಯಾಜ್ಞವಲ್ಕ್ಯ. ಸೊ ಯಾಜ್ಞವಲ್ಕ್ಯ ಋಷಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಇಬ್ಬರು ಹೆಂಡರಿ ಹೇಳಿದೇವರು. ಯಾಜ್ಞವಲ್ಕ್ಯ ವಾಸ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮನಿ, ಈವನ್ ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಅರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಮನಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಬಿಗ್ ಆಶ್ರಮ್, ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಮೆನಿ ಡಿಸೈಪಲ್ಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ಎ ಬಿಗ್ ಆಶ್ರಮ್. ಸೊ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಗೋ ಟು ನಾಟ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ ಟುಗೆದರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನಿ. ಸೇಮ್ ಸೇಮ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಮೈತ್ರಿ, ಅದೇ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದೆ. ಸೊ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಎವೇ. ಹಿ ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ಎ ಆಶ್ರಮ್, ಹಿ ಟಾಟ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಯಜ್ಞವಲ್ಕ್ಯ ಋಷಿ. ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಸೆಡ್ ಓಕೆ, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್, ಹಿ ಕೇಮ್ ಟು ಎ ಪೀಕ್, ಎಲ್ಲ ಉನ್ನತಿ ಬಂತು. ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ. ನೌ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್, ಎ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೌ ಡಸ್ ಇ ವೈ ಡಸ್ ಇ ಟೇಕ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ. ದರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ, ಎರಡು ರೀತಿಯ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಇದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಎ ನಾನ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸೀಕರ್. ಸೀಕರ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಅ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೀಕರ್. ದೆನ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಆಫ್ ದ ನೋವರ್, ಜ್ಞಾನಿ. ಯಜ್ಞವಲ್ಕ್ಯ ಸನ್ಯಾಸಿ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಆಫ್ ದ ನೋವರ್, ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಸೀಕರ್. ಸೊ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಅ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್? ಸೊ ಎ ಸೀಕರ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಟು ಡೆಡಿಕೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ. ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಓವರ್, ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಡೂ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಡೂ. ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಜನ ಬಂದು ಕಿರಿಕಿರಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ. ಸೊ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಆದ ಸೀಕರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಆದ ನೋವರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ಗುರು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆತ್ಮ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆತ್ಮ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮನ್, ಶ್ರವಣ ಮನನ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡೂ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಓವರ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ 10,000 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್, 50,000 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇರೋ ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇದಾಂತ.
So this repetition and to abide in the self is mainly to vasanakshaya.
And that makes a difference between four types of jnanis. I'll tell you four types of jnanis. Brahmavid, Brahmavara, Brahmavarenya, Brahmavarishtha. There are four types of jnanis. Depending on how much vasanakshaya they do. So, ಆತ್ಮಜ್ಞಾನ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ದ ಡೇ ಯು ರಿಸೀವ್ ಅ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಗುರು ಇನ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ವೇ. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಎಂಟರ್ ಇಂಟು ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್. ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಸೀಕಿಂಗ್, ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಗುರು, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಜ್ಞಾನ. you have to find some other place, somewhere else. Means you have to continue. That means that the Adnana has not gone. See, Adnana going one time is one thing, Vasanakshaya is another thing. Vasanakshaya is a slow process. Atmadnana is one time process. What I call that? Atmadarshana. Vasanakshaya ke tum puna puna kudubeko. Vasanakshaya yeshta agate, adhamele Brahma with Brahma vala, Brahma vala inna, Brahma vala inna, nal kriti, nal urta. Adham nana one next class rate then. Okay. Any questions?
No, this is one sadhana,
alva. Sadhana, alva. Nididhyasa is not a sadhana.
It is not sadhana.
Non-doing is not a sadhana. Doing is a sadhana.
Okay. But what I am telling is, for example, in the transactional world, after all this, is it wrong then to again read the scriptures or listen to people or
No. The question is, what is your purpose? What is your purpose? Are you seeking Atma?
No, I'm saying. I'm not seeking. I find joy.
I'm saying. Are you seeking Atmadnana? Okay. Or the seeking has ended and giving has started. Or seeking is going on. Is the question. That's the difference.
But joy is seeking.
That's what I'm saying. That is giving. There's a difference between seeking and giving. Seeking is, still I have to know something. That's called seeking. Okay, I know this, I am giving. That is called giving. So, after Atmadnana, giving happens by many people. That's called Brahmavid category. If that is not happening, then seeking continues. Oh, there's something missing in me. That is called seeking. In that seeking, we start study of that. I have to go more deeper. That's called seeking. For giving, you study. That is not seeking. That is giving. Seeking and giving, difference you have to know. Understand? Now, if you say that I have still not understood, the seeking is continuing. Something is missing in me. No, I have understood this, all it is. Now I have to give. Then you may do study and give. Because for giving, you may not do some preparation. That's not doing. That's non-doing. Have you understood the difference between doing and non-doing?
That I have understood, I am talking about the third situation. That I reach the stage, as you said again, giving, not giving, that will all the universe will take care. Mm-hmm. If it has to happen, it will happen, it is not.
Right.
But I have to live, the body is there, the prarabdha, the body has to go on. And I find joy in my transactional world. Spending time on satsang.
That's what I'm trying to know. I'm telling you, that's exactly what I'm trying to tell you. See, there's a seeking and giving. A jnani also can go to a music concert, jnani also can dance. Doesn't make a difference. The question is, have I got Atma Jnana, have a gap or not? That's the question. Right? So that is the question of jnana. Everything else you do is a transaction. Okay, for a transaction purpose, for a transaction you may go to a movie, you may go to a cinema, or you may go to a satsang. It doesn't make a difference. The question is not about that, what you do. Question is what you are. What I am, is there still gap? That's called gap in Atmadhar. Then the seeking has not ended. No, this is what it is. Understanding is called end of knowledge. That's called realization. So when you say in Vedanta, the moment jnana comes, realization happens means this. Okay. So now you understand I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am not the transaction entity. Then there is a freedom. That freedom which you feel is called jnana. Now if that freedom is not feeling, again it is coming back because of the vasana. So then again you go and sit nididhyasa. So there is a difference between sadhana for siddhi and sadhana after siddhi. This distinction is there. So does it answer your question?
No. What I feel is, see, the transactional world is very much connected with the spiritual thing.
There's no difference. There's no difference.
Okay. Now, but as you say, even at Rani, everybody has to do something.
Yeah, there's no difference.
So what I'm telling is, suppose the has to do something, as you say, you can go for a movie, you can go for a dance, you can go for a picnic, you can go, whatever, that doesn't matter, as long as you're revealing in Brahman, you know what, that doesn't. But suppose go to a satsang, suppose I read a book on spirituality,
What you do doesn't matter. What is more, motivation matters.
Okay,
I'll ask you a question. Somebody takes a knife and cuts the stomach of a person and the person dies. So, what do you call that person as?
A murderer.
He's a murderer, right? He's a criminal. Now I say, the person who took the knife and cut the stomach was a doctor. He was doing a surgery and the patient died. What is this? What is he?
He's
a noble intention. Action doesn't speak about
the motivation.
The motivation is action. Karma is not action. Karma is the motivation behind the action. So, Atmadnani can very well be anywhere. But the question is, what motive he is doing depends on the Atman. That's about Atmadnani, not about what he does. So there are four types of Atmadani. Brahmavid, Brahmavara, Brahmavarena, Brahmavarishta. So Brahmavid gets his jnana. Okay, then he comes back and he performs his duties in the world. He is like a normal Elragirtanam. Janaka Maharaja was one example. Okay, Sri Krishna was another example of a jnani, completely involved in the world. Then there are many people, jnanis, who just get involved in the world and nobody knows they are jnanis. They are just perfectly they do it for Loka Kalyana. Whatever is that? Loka Kalyana. That's called Brahmavid category. Now what Nani is doing there is there are vasanas are there. Vasanas to serve the world. Chinmayananda. Chinmayananda as well could have started in Jangangotri. Kutkoli daru. Nanukogi either Matakan theatre. Yelige Gita Nanel. Our Guru Rajavana Rajavana Vasana Hoka Paman theatre. So Chinmayananda in the Murti Valley Kaldre, he cannot come back. Yanagate, the more you sit in Samadhi, Sahaja Samadhi, the more your vasanas decrease, then more you will not be able to, serve this society. So the question is, there is a balance between how much you nididhyasa you do, how much you interact with the society. So if you have to do more vasanakshaya, the social interaction will come down. So that comes, brings him from Brahmavid to Brahmavara category. Brahmavara category, social interaction will come down. Brahmavarena category, social interaction is very less. Brahmavarishta category, the example is Ramana Maharshi. There are no social interactions. So, but jnana is same for all of them. Jnana, there no. But the manifestation of jnana is less because of the vasana which is there, pending vasana. Pending vasana is not mukti ki vasana. Mukti ki sashte. It is vasana residual prarabdha karma. Residual prarabdha karma makes a difference. A residual prarabdha karma takes some jnani to yatra, some jnani, something gets. You read it, Vithyarangaru. Our residual vasana is with Dudman Burtu. He got so much of money that he donated to Vijayanagara Empire. So residual vasana will start giving fruit. Now whatever is required, either you do it or you don't do it, it's up to you. Okay? But you have to have clarity what is jnana, what is not jnana. Clarity what is the sadhana before jnana and after jnana. That's what I'm trying to tell you. So do this, don't this is not a what you do doesn't matter. With what is the intention, what is the motivation? Oh, this aspect of jnana is not clear to me, find out. Okay? Not necessary that you have to end one point after. But this is not clear, you have to find out. Okay, this part is not clear, you have to find out. Then seeking is going on. The seeking is going on or seeking is ended is the question. Seeking will end only with the clarity. Until the clarity comes, seeking doesn't end. For that you need to do effort. That's called Shastra Shastra Jnana for seeking. Now there is Shastra Jnana after realization also. But there is more for teaching and Loka Kalyana. So there are differences. That's the difference I am pointing out. Is it clear? What you do doesn't matter whether it's in even world also. I give you example of doctor and murderer. The difference is intention. Okay. Let us close for the day.
Residual vasanas. No? So once that is also overall the mukti happens. So
no.
Mukti
the moment you get clarity of the Atma and Anatma. Who am I? And if you are able to do Nididhyasa, that's all. then whatever is there is residual prarabdha karma. It is there, you want to remove it, you don't want to remove it, it's up to you. But mukti is not after that. Mukti is that moment. That's what meant by your, what did you say? You said, no? Shastra, Atmadarshana, Bandhukulla, liberation happens?
Atmadarshana.
Realization or recognition.
No, no. What I'm saying is, you said something, no? Realization, the moment happened, realization, mukti happens. That is the meaning of that. So, even one time you know that this is not rope, this is not snake rope, it's over. Next time you don't have to put torch to find out if it's a rope or not. Right? The Atmadhyana clarity has to come one time and once for all. If it has not come, the seeking is going on. Nothing wrong in that. That's the way. But if it has come, that is the end. Then there will be some vasanas, but this residual vasanas, they will not affect your mukti. They are not bonded, they are not blocked for the mukti. They are residual prarabdha karma kept as a part of the universe to help you to teach and do loka kalyana.
Okay, I think that is what everybody mistake the thing. Like once the vasanas are completely over, only the
atmadhyana. Vasana kshaya has nothing to do with atmadhyana. Okay, 100%. There are vasanas for 100, so there are 2 or 3 blocking vasanas are there. 98 vasanas remaining. The 2 or 3 blocking vasanas go because of some punya and you get atmadhyana, that's all over. Then 98 either you can remove it or they can be removed. But that the two vasanas will not block your mukti. 98 vasanas. They will get exhausted in the prarabdha karma. And they may get a cancer like Ramana Maharshi. They may get a cancer like this thing also. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. So it can result in any of these. But what is jnana, what is adjnana, you have to be very clear. Let's close for the day.